Okay, children, we saw about the Aligarh movement started by Sir Syed Ahmad Khan and the Deoband movement started by the Orthodox Muslim Ulemas. Muslim Ulemas. Understand? And they didn't give importance to no Western education. Can you able to follow? Now we are going to see about the Parsi movement. Parsi movement. Third one. The Parsi people. Sir Syed Ahmad Khan Aligarh movement and Deoband movement, second movement, and the third one is Parsi movement. Here in the 19th century, the Parsi movement, it was started in Mumbai. Where it was started? It was started in Mumbai. And Fardunji, say all of you, Fardunji, Nauroji. Founded the Ranumai Mastayasnan. Mastayasnan. Understand? So Sabha. Abdinte, he started a Sabha. It was a Parsi Reform Society in the year 1851. Understand? Then Rust Goftar was the main voice of the movement. Main voice na navarda adapati naraya eduthu sonnavar. He only gave much importance. Understand? And Behramji Malabre organized a campaign for the legislation against the practice of child marriage. Child marriage irka kudade. Understand? We should not follow child marriage. So the Parsi people, they fought against child marriage. And the community produced many leaders, such as, you know, nariya leaders irundanga, Feroz Shah Mehta and Dinsha Wacha, who played a big role in the yearly Congress. They participated in the Congress also. Okay, then next one, Sikh movement. Sikhism solrole, adha Sikh movement. Here, among the Sikh of Punjab, Sikhs enga irukanga nama paathom, they are in Punjab. They also started many attempts to give reforms to the people. Adala Baba Dayal Das, he was the founder of Nirankar movement. Adala, there are two important movements are there in Sikh movement. They are Nirankar movement. Nirankari movement. And another one is Namdaris movement. Namdari movement. The Sikh movement, it have two types. Understand? One was Nirankari movement and another one was Namdari movement. Here, this Yare Baba Dayal Das, he only founded the Nirankari movement. Understand? That is formless. God was the formless. Avarku endha idol worship, adha uruvam kadaiyadhe. Okay? He was, what we can say, he was formless. And they, they fought against the idolatry. Idolatry in the sense, idol worship pannuvaangalla, adhala irukka kudadhe. And there was no image in the temples. Understand? Avangaloda worship pandra place la nama poi paathona, there was no idols also. And the avangaloda important book, this Sikhism was founded by Guru Nanak. Our found pan and the book da enada ipa, for an example, Bhagavad Gita is the sacred book for the Hindus. The Holy Bible is the sacred book for the Christian people and Quran is the holy book for the Muslims. And the Madri, Adi Granth is the holy book for the sacred book for the Sikhs. Understand? So, he followed this Adi Granth. This is only the essence of teaching. So, if we learn Adi Granth, we can attain salvation. Abdin Solita was told. And also, he reiterated thus the prohibition of meat eating. Yara meat saabda kuda adu. Meat in an envy. Non-veg is told. Adha yara saabda kuda adu sold. Then, didn't accept the liquor consumption also. No one should take liquor na kudikirangala. Adala arka kuda adu. So, no one should take meat as well as liquor. Abdinte yaar sonnadu? This Niramkari movement. Baba Dayal Das. Understand? And another movement I told you, it was Namdhari movement. In Namdhari movement, it was started by Baba Ram Singh. Another social reform movement for the Sikhs. Understand? And he started the Namdhari movement, that is in idol form. And அவங்களுக்கு மெயினாக எந்த இருக்கக்கூடாது அப்படின்னு சொன்னால் தே ஆர் பேரிங் த சிம்பிள்ஸ் ஆஃப் சீக்கிசம் ஆல் த சிம்பிள்ஸ் ஆஃப் சீக்கிசம் எக்ஸப்ட் த ஸ்வாட் நீங்கள் பார்த்துருக்கீங்களா இந்த சீக் பீப்புளெலாம் ஒரு ஸ்வாட் வச்சுருப்பாங்க மோஸ்ட்லி ஸ்வாடுன்னு என்ன கத்தி மாதிரி இருக்கும்ல அதை இடுப்பில் சொருகியிருப்பாங்க ஆனால் இந்த நம்தாரி மூமெண்ட் அவர் என்ன சொல்கிறாரு வாட் ஹீ செட் வி ஷுட் நாட் யூஸ் திஸ் ஸ்வாட் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் அப்படின்ட்டு தட் இஸ் கால்ட் அ ஸ்கிர்பன் நோ ஸ்வாட் Instead of Baba Ram Singh, he followed the followers. Instead of carrying the sword, we have to carry lathi. Lathi na ena? Stick. The police alla vachirupangala, the police will have the stick, rod. And the lathi, it is called as lathi. Adha vena vachikalam, we should not use the sword. Like that, he said. And both men and women, they are having the equal rights. In Namdhari movement and they gave importance to widow remarriage. Understand, widows can remarry. அப்படின்னு அவங்க சொல்கிறாங்க. They prohibited dowry system and child marriage. Okay. So, in the after this Arya Samaj and many Christian missionaries, they came into India. They started the Singh Sabhas of Amritsar. Amritsar is in Punjab. So, அங்கே நிறைய கான்ஃபரன்ஸ் எல்லாம் வச்சாங்க ஃபார் த ரிவைவல் ஆஃப் சீக்கிசம் ஓகே அண்ட் தே ஸ்டார்டட் த கல்சா காலேஜ் ஃபார் த சீக்ஸ் இன் அம்ரித்சர் ஸோ தீஸ் ஆர் அபவுட் திஸ் சீக் மூமெண்ட் அண்ட் தே ஃபவுண்ட் ஸ்டார்டட் அ வெரி கிரேட் மூமெண்ட் இட் வாஸ் கால்ட் அஸ் அகாலி மூமெண்ட் நவ் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு சி அபவுட் த சோஷியல் ரிஃபார்மர்ஸ் ஆஃப் தமிழ்நாடு Social reformers of Tamil Nadu. Here, this Ramalinga Swamigal, Kelipattirukingla, he was popularly called as Vallalar. Vallalar. Ramalinga Swamigal. He was popularly called as Vallala. And he born to in where he was born Vallala, he was born in Marudur near Chidambaram, a village near Chidambaram. And after his father's death, he came to Chennai. And he had no any formal education, but he had the scholarship. And immense scholarship and he formulated, he started to learn the education, understand, with the help of the scholarship. And he had much compassion in all, okay, what is meant by compassion, children? Irakkam, understand? So, he had much compassion, irakkapadradhan solrala, adhi ellar meliyam avarukku irundhuchan compassion, even he had the compassion on plants also, understand? And he called, this was called as Jeeva Karunya. This was called as Jeeva Karunya. This Ramalinga Adigal, he followed this Jeeva Karunya. Understand? And he started the Samarasa Veda Sanmarga Sangam. See all of you? Samarasa Veda Sanmarga Sangam in the year 1865, and it renamed as Samarasa Suddha Sanmarga Satya Sangha, which means Society for Pure Truth in Universal Selfhood. And he gave importance to free feeding na enna ilavasa unavu solrom la adha free feeding to the each and every house irrespective of caste creed avanga endha jaathiya irundhalum endha madama irundhalum ellarku enna kuduthaanga avanga and the movement moolama they gave free food to all the people during famine in the year 1866 la a great famine occurred in India. So he gave, and he sang many songs also. Understand? These songs are called as Thiruppavai, Thiruvaruppa. These songs were called as Thiruvaruppa. நீங்க தமிழ் புக்லாம் நீங்க பார்த்துருக்கலாம் திருவருட்பா இல்ல நீங்க படிச்சிருப்பீங்க இல்ல தமிழ் புக்ல ஸ்டார்டிங்லேயே இருக்கும். So this was written by this great Vallalar. His name was Ramalinga Swamigal. அவங்க தான் இதை ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணது. Next one, அயோத்திதாசர். Another great leader, he was அயோத்திதாசர். அயோத்திதாசர். This Pandita Ayothidasar was a radical Tamil scholar. He was a Tamil scholar, writer, Siddha medicine practitioner, journalist, socio-political activist. So all these, what we can say, character he belonged to. He had the talents. என்னவாலாம் இருந்தார் அவர் பண்டிதர் அயோத்திதாசர் என்ன ஃபஸ்ட்டு ஸ்காலர் தமிழ் ஸ்காலர் தென் ரைட்டர் ஹி வாஸ் அ கிரேட் ரைட்டர் தென் சித்தா மெடிசனில் ப்ராக்டிஷ்னர் சித்தா மெடிசன் நல்லா அவருக்கு தெரியும் ஓகே ஆயுர்வேதிக் யுனானி அந்த மாதிரிலாம் மெடிசன் இருக்குல்ல அது சித்தா மெடிசன் ஹி நோ தென் ஹி வாஸ் அ ஜேர்னலிஸ்ட் ஆல்சோ அண்ட் ஹி வாஸ் அ சோஷியோ பொலிட்டிக்கல் ஆக்டிவிஸ்ட் He was born in Chennai, and so for that he learnt all the languages like Tamil, English, Sanskrit and Pali languages. He know 4 languages. Understand? Tamil, English, Sanskrit and Pali languages. He campaigned for the social justice and emancipation of the untouchabilities. Understand? Untouchability in Damai Soltron Lam. Understand that low caste people, high caste people, they won't touch the low caste people. Understand? And there is a separate place for them, temple for them, bath, ellame avanga separate avangaloda village they'll have separately untouchables. Understand? And he worked for the construction of casteless society. Understand? He gave much important to education. Education is very important. He said this, Pandita Ayothidasa said, education is very important to people. And so he started many schools and for the untouchables in Tamil Nadu. ஏன்னா அவங்களுக்குலாம் இந்த லோ காஸ்ட் பீப்புள்க்கெலாம் அந்த காலத்தில் ஸ்கூலே இல்லை அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் ஸோ ஃபார் தட் ஹீ ஸ்டார்டட் மெனி ஸ்கூல்ஸ் ஃபார் த அன்டச்சபிள்ஸ் அண்ட் பண்டித அயோத்திதாச ஃபவுண்டர் த அத்வைத நந்த சபா சே ஆல் ஆஃப் யூ அத்வைத நந்த சபா Atvaidananda Sabha. He started this. Okay. And through this he gave voice to the untouchables. And in 1882, John Ratnam and Ayothidasa established a great movement. It was called as Dravida Kalagam. He started this Dravida Kalagam. And he launched a magazine called Dravida Pandian in the year 1883. 5. And he founded the Dravida Mahajan Sabha in 1891 and organized the first conference at Nilgiris. Understand, these are all about Ayodhyadasar. And Pandita Ayodhyadasar was disappointed about the Hindus' ritualism, Hindu practices. Understand, because in Hinduism, the very important prominent position was given to the Brahmins only. So, அதுலேயே நிறைய caste சிஸ்டம்லாம் இருந்தது. The untouchables, the low caste people, and the Brahmins and the high class people, they won't give much importance to the low caste people. So, on seeing all the problems, on seeing the rituals and the rights of the people, he converted into Buddhism. Understand? And the theosophic organizer, Colonel H.S. Alcott, along with this H.S. Alcott, he went to Sri Lanka and he converted to Buddhism. Understand? In the same year, he founded the Sakya Buddhist Society at Madras. Madras, he started a movement, religious movement for Buddhism. Understand? He started to propagate Buddhism also. And he started one weekly journal. It was called as Oru Paisa Tamilan. See all of you? Oru Paisa Tamilan. He founded a weekly, that is weekly journal, book. Understand? Weekly and the Oru book varo. Okay. And published until his death. So, they are all about the social reform and religious reform movements of India. Understand? In next chapter, we'll see about the what we can say, this Veerapandiya Kattabomman, Oomaitorai, Pulithevar, the Palayakaras, avungala eppadi, understand, in the political condition of India, this is social and religious condition of India, and in the next chapter we are going to see about the political condition of India. Understand, in this already we saw about this Raja Ram Mohan Roy, and he started this Arya Samaj, and Brahma Samaj. Raja Ram Mohan Roy started Brahma Samaj, and this Arya Samaj was founded by Swami Dayananda Saraswati. They all forced this, the Dayananda Saraswati forced the Hindu revivalism. Understand? And this Muslims also, we have the reform movements, and Aligarh movement and Deoband movement, both of them, they were belong to Islam, that is Muslim movement. And the Parsis also, we have the movement. It was started by Fardunji Nauroji in Mumbai. Understand? For the Sikhs also, we got the movement. Okay? In Punjab, there were two blocks. They were Nirankari and Namdari. Okay, adaliye rendu divisions, two divisions. And we saw about the social reformers in Tamil Nadu. This Ramalinga Swamigal, he was called as Vallalar. And this Ayodhyadasar, Pandita Ayodhyadasar. So, these are all about the social and religious reform movements in India. Okay, children, learn well, thorough it. This lesson will come for you in the next exam. Thank you, children.